So good morning, chemistry second year, English medium. Unit is surface chemistry, topic is applications of colloids. Let's see. So colloids are widely used in the industry. So what are the applications? Let's see. So first one is electrical precipitation of smoke, purification of drinking water, medicines, tanning, cleansing action of soaps and detergents, photographic plates and films, rubber, industrial products. Okay, so in various ways colloidal forms are obtained. So let's see. Yes, electrical precipitation of smoke. His smoke is a colloidal solution of solid particles such as carbon, arsenic compounds, dust, etc. in air. The smoke before it comes out from the chimney is led through a precipitator containing plates having a charge opposite to the smoke particles. On coming in contact with these plates, lose their charge and get precipitated. So the particles thus settle down on the floor of the chamber. This is happened in electrical precipitation of smoke. So what happens is, in general, you know about smoke. Smoke is nothing but what? It is the combination of dust particles, arsenic compounds, carbon compounds present in air. Okay, when air is associated with the carbon particles, arsenic compounds, then dust particles, then that is called as smoke. Okay, then so this smoke causes a lot of pollution. It is very dangerous to living beings. Okay, living beings. Then yes, in order to purify the smoke, then what happens is electrical precipitation method is applied. Okay, then yes, here is the smoke before it comes out. The smoke before it comes out from chimney, especially in industries, okay, then so the smoke before it comes out from the chimney, it is passed through the precipitator which is having the plates which are opposite charge to the smoke. When the smoke is passing on the plates, what happens is the smoke particles are having the charge, then the plates are having the opposite charge. As a result of that, yes, the charge of the smoke particles can be neutralized. Then what happens? The smoke particles can be coagulated. The smoke particles can be aggregated. Then the smoke particles can be precipitated. Okay, these precipitated smoke particles are settled down in the chamber. Then is for electrical precipitation method, there is a precipitator is a Cottrell precipitator is used. Cottrell precipitator is used. Okay, so this is the very useful industrial method to stop the pollution, air pollution. As a result of this method, what happens? The smoke is separated. So the smoke is separated from the arsenic compounds, dust particles, carbon compounds. Okay, so most of the pollutants can be separated by this method. Then next one is purification of drinking water. Then so what happens? Then how the water is purified? Then so the water obtained from natural sources often contains suspended impurities. Alum is added to such water to coagulate the suspended impurities and make water fit for drinking purpose. Okay, then water is in general available from the natural resources. Natural resources like there is a river water, a surface water. Okay, then so this water is associated with a lot of impurities which are suspended in the water. This water must be purified. So how this is happened is, yes, in order to remove the suspended impurities from the river water, then what happens? The water is collected in tanks and added to that water. Here is a alum. Okay, this alum, there is a alum. What happens is the alum is a coagulate the impurities, suspended impurities present in river water. Then what happens? Then the clay particles or impurities are settled down. Then sedimentation takes place. Then yes, the purified water occupies the upper level. So this is the way of purification of water by technique of coagulation technique, by adding alum to the water. Then next one is medicines. There is a medicines. Most of the medicines are colloidal form in nature. So colloidal medicines are more effective because they have large surface area and therefore easily assimilated. Okay, then most of the medicines are colloidal form. Yes, why do we use a colloidal state of medicines? Is when the medicine is in colloidal state, the colloidal particles are having larger surface area. Due to this reason, yes, they can be easily adsorbed. Then yes, they can be easily sunk into the receptors. Okay, receptors. Then examples, as here is a argyrol. Argyrol is a silver sole used as eye lotion. Is a colloidal antimony is used in curing kalazar. Then colloidal gold is used as intramuscular injection. Milk of magnesia, an emulsion used for stomach disorders. Okay, so these are the colloidal state medicines. Argyrol is what? It is a silver sole used for eye lotion. Okay, used as eye lotion. Then next one, in general, here is a milk of magnesia, magnesium hydroxide. This is used for stomach disorders. Next one is, here is a gold sole. It is used as intramuscular injection. Okay, intramuscular injection. Then another application is, here is a tanning. What is meant by tanning is simply, here is a, in tanning process, here is a leather. Tanning process is in general used in leather industry. Then yes, animal skins are colloidal in nature. That is, so these skins are having the positive charged particles. When animal skins are interacted with the tannins. Okay, tannins. These are having a negative charged. Okay, negative charge. Then what happens is the positive charged particles of skin neutralized with the tannins. As a result of that, coagulation is happened. So as a result of coagulation, hardening of skin is happened. That is called as leather. Okay, so this tanning process, in general, it is used in leather industry. Then so by this process, there is what? Purification of leathers Then next one is to convert the skin into leather is happened by this process. In this process, basically animal skins are the positive souls. As animal skins are example help for these positive souls. These positive souls are associated with the tannins. Okay, tannins in general they can be considered as alkaloids. Then are having the negative charge. Okay, this negative charge. Then the positive charge skins associated with the negative charge tannins. Then yes, a neutralization takes place. Coagulation is happened. As a result of coagulation, then hardening of skin is happened. That is called as leather. Okay. So this is the process which is carried out in leather industry. Then for instead of a tannins, it is a chromium salts. Chromium salts are used. Then next one is cleansing action of soaps and detergents. Then yes, a soap. Soap is a example for colloid. Okay, so sodium or potassium salts of stearates is called as here is a soap. Then next one is a soap and detergents action. Cleansing action. Yes, what happens when, yes, here is a especially here is a oil or dirt. When yes, a oil drops or oil is affixed with the, there is a cloth. What happens in order to remove the water, dirt, particles from the cloth. What happens when we apply the, here is a detergents, then so these are detergent particles, colloidal particles can form the micellae around the dirt particles. Then yes, this micellae already discussed. Here is a because of formation of micellae, what happens is the detergent particles are having the, here is a lyophobic and a lyophilic two ends. Okay, the lyophobic end is our hydrocarbon end is mixed with the dirt particles. Then next one, hydrophilic part is outside of the dirt. Then this is associated, hydrophilic part is associated with the water molecules. Then it's a more number of detergent particles surrounded with the dirt particle. Then so this dirt particle is removed and it is drawn into the water molecule. So that is cleansing action or cleaning action of detergent and soap. So this is all by means of colloidal formation. Okay, then next one is photographic plates and films. Then yes, so the developing of photographic plates and films also based on the colloidal form. Then yes, how is the glass plates coated with silver bromide. Here is a silver. Why do we take silver bromide? It is a light sensitive material. Okay, so silver bromide is a chemical, yes, which is light sensitive. That's why the silver bromide is taken in a colloidal form, which is applied over the glass plates or here is a films. What happens then, here is it is act as a light sensitive. Then yes, we can use it as photographic plates and films. Okay, so in photographic plates and films, silver bromide colloidal form is taken and is applied over the surface of plates and films. Then next one is rubber. So rubber, so what is meant by rubber is in general, here is this is a rubber is extracted. Rubber is extracted from the, yes, here is a rubber plants, Hevia brasiliensis. Then yes, this Hevia brasiliensis secretes the, here is a latex. Okay, this latex is associated with this latex is having the rubber particles which are, here is a negative charged, okay, negative charge. Then these negative charged rubber particles are, yes, coagulated. Then, yes, here is what, here is a latex. Latex is coagulated. Then, yes, here is a rubber is obtained. Okay, so first of all, here is a rubber is the final state. Okay, it first of all, the rubber is in the form of a latex. Okay, so this latex is an example for the collide, okay, yes, which is having the negative soul. It is considered as negative soul. When it is coagulated, then it is converted into, here is a thick rubber or solid rubber is formed. Okay, in this process, in the manufacture of a rubber, there is a coagulation process is involved. This coagulation is done because of the it is a colloidal state. Okay, then next one is industrial products. Okay, most of the industrial products are in the form of a colloidal state. Yes, water, yes, here is a paints, inks, then lubricants, next one synthetic plastics, graphite, cement, all are the colloidal forms. Okay, it's a industrial products means, there is a industrial products, so these are the we are using in day to day life. Paints, ink, okay, ink, then this ink is used to write. Then next one, here is a lubricants. So lubricants in general, they are used in machinery parts to remove the friction. Then next one is a synthetic plastics, here is a polymers, all these are considered as, here is next one is a graphite, then cement, all are in colloidal states. Okay, so this is about applications of colloids. So once again, here is what electrical precipitation of smoke. Then next one is a purification of drinking water, then medicines, tanning process, then cleansing action of soaps and detergents, then next one photographic plates and films, then rubber, then next one industrial products. Okay, so these are the applications of colloids.